Vids, 0900 back here with another video today, and in today's video there is some huge news right now, breaking news about the current captain of the Warriors in the fullback, Roger Tuivasa Sheck. He's officially confirmed he will be leaving the club, the Warriors, at the end of the 2021 season to join New Zealand Rugby Union in 2022. So that's massive news right there. And I know that the whole news came out on Thursday, but I couldn't do a video on Thursday because Friday I had school and it was the first I had to go back and all that. But now, since it's official and I can make a video about Roger Tuivasa Sheck going to the Rugby Union in 2022, I'll be giving you all my thoughts and opinions on it. Now, look, I'll start by saying that there is a history of a lot of players from NRL going to Rugby Union, such as Marika Korobeti, Siliasi Vunivalu, Simi Radradra. Right now RTS, he's going to go there now, you know, and Israel Folau, Carmichael Hunt, just trying to think of anyone else. And there's been some like younger players like from the old grades that I know of, but probably maybe you don't. There was someone called Watson Halletia from the West Tigers, and Johnny Walker used to play for Manly in the lower grades, went to Rugby Union, but no one really knows them. But yeah, look, there's been a history of Rugby Union taking some of our NRL talent and players. Oh yeah, Tom Wright, who used to play for Manly, that young guy. It's really wrong in my opinion. I don't like how there's players leaving NRL for Rugby Union. I mean, this is our talent we breed. This is our like Rugby League talent we breed. And why can't Rugby Union, you know, produce their own, you know, young products in their game? You know, it's just, I don't think it's right. But anyway, we're focusing on RTS going to Rugby Union, not about why Rugby Union is stealing our talent, which they are, but that's not the main point of the video. The main point of the video is about Roger Tuivasa Sheck going to New Zealand Rugby. Now this is a big loss to the Warriors. I think I don't know if this will be a distraction for the 2021 season. Even though RTS hasn't left yet, he'll be going in 2022 to New Zealand Rugby Union. But in 2021, does his situation put the Warriors in a bit of a worry or a bit of a distraction because of his move next year? I don't know if that affects the Warriors, but you know, it could in some way. But when he leaves, the Warriors have a big hole of feeling. Like, who's their captain for 2022? Then will it be Tahu Harris? I think Tahu Harris could be a good option for the captain. Maybe Chanel Harris-Tavita. I'm not sure. I mean, they have some options. I guess they could take over as captain in the future when RTS leaves. But they also need a good fullback. So I understand Charles Clockstead's off contract. Around the end of November this year. He's eligible to talk about clubs in. So maybe the Warriors can bring him back home. That'd be amazing if they did that. I mean, Jerome Hughes is an option, maybe. He's been in talks with the Warriors, Jerome Hughes. There's a young, good fullback. Well, there's two young, good fullbacks, actually, that have the Warriors. Have Rocco Berry and Paul Turner. I've heard of their highly rated young players, and they could maybe give them a go to replace RTS in the future. I'm not sure. But Warriors, they do have some options to replace RTS, but even though they have options, Warriors, to replace Roger Tuivasa Sheck, a guy like RTS is really hard to replace. He's such a great leader, such a talent. You know, his steps and, you know, his sidesteps, he's got some good speed. You know, he's just a freak of a player. He's a complete package of a player you want in your team. So I think him leaving the Warriors at the end of the year, it's going to be really tough for their fans and their whole team in general. But, you know, that's his decision. I can't stop him from going to Rugby Union, and Warriors fans can't either. But I know it's going to be upsetting for the Warriors. And if I was a Warriors fan, I'd be pretty upset as well, actually. But I'm also upset because he's leaving the game. He's leaving the game NRL, which is a fantastic game, one of the best games in Australia, if not the best game in Australia and across the other countries and all that. It's just so sad to leave him, see him go, but... Oh well, best of luck to Roger Tuivasa Sheck and Rugby Union, I'd say. But guys, that's the end of the video. Huge news. What do you think about it? Do you think he'll go well there, or do you wish he stayed? Look, it's a big news, obviously, and we'll see how this impacts the Warriors. But guys, I'll catch you in the next video.